Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to another day experimenting with pyrotechnics. Today, we're going to be mixing a little nail polish remover with some ping pong balls to make nitrocellulose lacquer. Now, for a lot of my pyrotechnic experiments, I've used this viscofuse. This is falling leaves, but the problem with it is it's not waterproof, which means if it got wet or got submerged in a puddle of water, the fuse would go out. So the purpose of today's experiment is to use nail polish remover and ping pong balls to make a nitrocellulose coating, which will hopefully make it so our fuses can burn underwater. Seriously? Apparently it burns underwater. That's no good. Now, this is really interesting because last week when I was testing this experiment, all the fuses I put in water went out completely. But today, they all seem to be burning just fine. I've tried four different fuses and all of them burn underwater, so the results seem to be very inconsistent. But that's okay. We're going to go ahead and make nitro lacquer anyway because it's a really cool experiment and just because we can. So here's what we want to do. We want to get some kind of a small jar with a lid and a couple of these ping pong balls that you get at a sporting goods store. The ping pong balls from the dollar store will not work. They need to be these professional branded type ping pong balls you get at a sporting goods store. Now, if you got the right kind of ping pong balls, there's a really cool trick you might already be familiar with that happens when you touch it with a flame. Ping pong balls are highly flammable. They go up in flames very, very quickly and leave very little residue. And that's because these things are made mostly of nitrocellulose. So to make a nitrocellulose lacquer, all we have to do is take a few of these ping pong balls and use some nail polish remover to dissolve them. Things are gonna happen a lot quicker and easier if we start shredding our ping pong ball up into smaller pieces. So take something like a pair of scissors and cut them up into the smallest pieces you can get and drop them into a small jar. So here we are, guys. After about 2 minutes, we've got two ping pong balls reduced to very small pieces. Now all we have to do is transfer these pieces to our small glass container, add a little bit of nail polish remover and screw on the lid, then shake it up and wait. How much nail polish remover do we add? That is the question. I guess we're gonna experiment and find out. I'm gonna pour in enough just to come to the top of those pieces. All right, it's been a couple of minutes, and if we take the lid off now and take a look inside, you can see our crispy flakes of ping pong ball have turned into a goo. It's kind of turned mushy here. And I suppose the longer we let that sit in the acetone, the thinner and runnier it will become. But this is the goo that we're looking for. We're gonna thin that out a little bit more. You can see our ping pong balls have almost turned into a paste, almost like a paper mache paste. So this is pretty cool, guys. You can see that after just about 3 minutes, our ping pong balls have dissolved in the nail polish remover to form this goopy paste, which kind of looks like wallpaper paste. Now, if we add a little bit more nail polish remover, we can make this liquid even runnier. And in contrast, if we let it sit out for a while, the fumes will vaporize off and make the substance hard again. So theoretically, I suppose you could cast ping pong plastic into just about any shape you want. All right, let's open this thing up and see what we got here. Ooh, nice and creamy. It almost looks like school glue. Pyrotechnic Elmer's glue. I kept adding nail polish remover until all the big chunks dissolved, and now it's very smooth, very runny, and it's almost like paint, which means we could use it as a pyrotechnic coating. Nitrocellulose Lego. Love it. So nail polish remover is extremely flammable. Ping pong balls are extremely flammable. Do you think this stuff mixed together is extremely flammable? Oh yeah, very flammable. So we have just created a pyrotechnic paint. It makes me wonder what we could paint with it. Look at the nice shiny surface that creates. Pyrotechnic paint. Well, that looks cool, the patterns are burning. Huh?
Cool little nitro Legos.
It's amazing that when I put the fuse into the lacquer here, it softens up and becomes extremely flexible. Which makes me wonder if the coating isn't already infused with the nitrocellulose lacquer. I'm betting it probably is. Now that the lacquer has hardened, you can see the fuse has gone stiff again. It doesn't bend like it did before. Now it goes out. It works great before we applied the coating. Oh, that's weird. That's pretty cool. The nice thing about it is how quickly that burned off. Flammable paint. So now here we are, guys. We turned nail polish remover and some ping pong balls into a white mushy goop that I'm going to call pyrotechnic paint. And there are a few interesting things about its characteristics that we learned during these experiments today. We started our experiments today with ping pong balls and nail polish remover and the intent to make a waterproof coating for fuses. But in testing our fuses, we found that they already burn underwater, and that's probably because they've already got nitro lacquer built into them. We also found that we could change the consistency of our lacquer by adding more nail polish remover and stirring it in, or just by letting it sit out for a while so the acetone could evaporate. Next, we tried smearing this stuff on a piece of wood and found that it actually does work as a lacquer to help seal and preserve the finish. But we also realized that this lacquer is extremely flammable, and while it can be poured into any mold or painted onto any surface, if it comes into contact with any kind of a spark or a flame, things can get pretty hot pretty fast. Now for one final experiment, I wondered if we could make a firecracker that would burn off and explode underwater as well. But in testing those, we found that they just went off by themselves anyway. In a spectacular fashion, mind you. Ouch, my ears. Whoa! Dang! So there you have it, guys. Now you know how to turn nail polish remover and ping pong balls into pyrotechnic paint. Thanks for joining me for this set of experiments. I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. Let's just move that out of the way. Hey guys, thanks for watching, and remember, I'm giving away prizes now on every new video. All you have to do to qualify is subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and select to be notified when my next videos get released. The secret link to my giveaways will be pinned in the comments for the first 12 hours. If you like what I'm doing, show your support right now by giving this video a big thumbs up and share with a friend. I love you back, and I'll see you next time.